Good morning, children. In today's class, let us discuss the abolition of slavery in France, one of the most revolutionary social reforms of the Jacobean regime. Means Jacobean rule was the abolition of slavery in the French colonies. The colonies in the Caribbean, Martinique, Guadeloupe, and Saint Domingo, they were important suppliers of commodities such as tobacco. Indigo. Indigo is a tropical plant of pea family. It is cultivated as a source of dark blue color dye. And sugar, coffee. But the reluctance of Europeans means they were not ready to go to work in distant and unfamiliar lands. Because of this, there was a shortage of labor in the plantations. So they started a triangular slave trade between Europe, Africa, and the Americas. Slaves from Africa were taken to Europe and America, and they were sold in slave markets. Women and the Negroes who were poor were carried to Europe and they were sold there. And the slave trade, this is the triangle slave trade. This slave trade began in 17th century. French merchants who sailed from the ports of Bordeaux or Nantes to the African coast, they were brought slaves from the local chieftains. And they branded and shackled the slaves. They started to exploit slaves. And these slaves were packed tightly into ships for the 3 month long voyage across Atlantic to the Caribbean. They were carried in packed into the ships. They were sold to plantation owners. The plantation of slave labor made it possible to meet the growing demand in European markets for sugar, coffee, and indigo. Port cities like Bordeaux and Nantes, they owned their economic prosperity because of the rich flourishing slave trade. Throughout the 18th century, there was a little criticism of slavery in France. Nobody cared for the slaves. Then the National Assembly held long debates about whether the rights of man should be extended to all the French subjects, including those who were living in the colonies. But they did not pass any laws. They feared opposition from the businessmen whose incomes depended on the slave trade. It was finally the convention which in 1794 legislated and gave order to free all the slaves. In the French overseas, means who were held captives, they were freed. And this turned out to be a short-term measure. 10 years later, Napoleon again reintroduced slavery. Then the plantation owners understood their freedom as including the right to enslave African Negroes in pursuit of their economic interest, because they were profited by the slave trade. Finally, the slavery was abolished in French colonies in 1848. The revolution and everyday life. Can politics change the clothes people wear, the language they speak, or the books they read? The years following 1789 in France saw many such changes in the lives of men, women, and children. The revolutionary governments took it upon themselves to pass laws that could translate the ideas of liberty and equality into everyday practice. One important law that came into effect soon after the storming of the Bastille Fort in the summer of 1789 was the abolition of censorship. Censorship is a ban. In the old regime, all written material and cultural activities like books, newspapers, plays, dramas that could be published or performed only after they were being approved by the censors of the king. They used to cut or ban the unwanted content in the books, newspapers, and then came the Declaration of Rights of Man and Citizen that proclaimed freedom of speech and expression to be a natural right of a citizen. Newspapers, pamphlets, books, and printed pictures, they were flooded in many towns of France from where they traveled rapidly into the countryside. They all described and discussed the events and changes taking place in France. Freedom of press also meant that opposing views of events, what was happening in the state, that could be expressed freely. Everyone was convinced that on their right and position through the medium of print, they started writing songs, plays, dramas, and even the festival processions, which attracted large number of people. This was the only way they could convince and identify with the ideas such as liberty or justice given to the people. The political philosophers who wrote in a large scale in books, texts, which only a handful of or few people, educated people, could read this. In the textbook on page number 22, you can see a figure where a fat woman was subjected to the machine, a fat reducing machine for the treatment to reduce fatness. Napoleon Bonaparte. In 1804, he was crowned himself as Emperor of France. He set out to conquer neighboring European countries and captivating their possessions and dynasties and creating kingdoms. And he kept his members of family there. Napoleon saw his role as a modernizer of Europe. He introduced many laws such as the protection of private property and a uniform system of weighs and measures provided by the decimal system. Initially, many people saw Napoleon as a liberator who could bring freedom for the people. But soon the Napoleon armies came to be viewed everywhere as an invading force when he started capturing other countries. He was finally defeated at the Waterloo in 1815. Many of his measures that carried the revolutionary ideas of liberty and modern laws to other parts of Europe had an impact on the people long after Napoleon had left. Ideas of liberty and democratic rights were the most important legacy of the French Revolution. These spread from France to the rest of the Europe during the 19th century, where feudal systems were abolished. The colonized people, they reworked the idea of freedom from bondage into their movements to create a sovereign nation state, neither subjected to any other power, means they wanted a free state. Tipu Sultan and Raja Ram Mohan Rai were the two examples of individuals who responded to the ideas coming from revolutionary France. Raja Ram Mohan Rai was one of those who was inspired by new ideas that were spreading through the Europe at that time. The French Revolution and later the July Revolution, this excited his imagination. He could think and talk of nothing else when he heard the July Revolution in France in 1830. On his way to England at Cape Town, he insisted on visiting frigates, means warships, flying the revolutionary tricolor flag, though he had been temporarily lamed by an accident.